coming in for the very first session. Ah, there we have Gautam. Good evening, Gautam. How are you doing?
Good evening. Namaste.
Namaste, ji. And, you've got a really floral background behind you, a very colorful background. That's nice to see.
Well, there's some blessings of living in Delhi, you see. The hills are not very far.
We've had some good weather.
Yeah, we've had fabulous weather. Absolutely fabulous weather.
Great. So, people have already started coming in. So, I'm going to start off with introducing the Diwan, Gautam Anand, who, well, his passion for Hindustani poetry is only matched by his knowledge of Indian culinary history and his experience as a hotelier in India. I have to say, I'm giving you a very abbreviated description of his work, because if I had to like go through his entire resume, I mean, the session would be over before we even started. But so Gautam started his career with ITC in 1980. And since then, he has run or set up some of their top properties, including the ITC Kakatiya, the ITC Maurya, the Grand Chola Chennai, and most recently the Grand Bharat in Gurgaon. So as the VP for ITC Hotels, he was in charge of quality benchmarking and pre-opening operations. And they also launched some of their most well-known brands, Otimo, Royal Vega, India Pavilion, and one that many of us are now becoming very familiar with, and that is Fabel Chocolates. And apart from being a hotelier, he writes his own blog, Hindawi Kitchens, Kitchens of India History. He is also the founding vice president of the Cuisine Society of India and the founding of the Cuisine India Foundation, as well as an advisor to the Experience India Society. So in all of this, he also somehow finds the time to write Hindustani poetry under the pen name of Sharar. So Gautam, I'm going to ask you to start off with perhaps reciting some poetry which kind of captures the mood of the moment.
Yes, so apart from all the rubbish that you read, my claim to fame is that I'm a great friend of Antoine, and he's very unforgiving about my pronunciations. So now I am saying it, hello, Antoine. All right. Okay, so once you told me the topic
contact
challenge, contactless dining, I sort of got very confused, and I wrote out something which I'll try and read out and then translate. Okay. Mm-hmm. It says, aina hoon main. Aina means mirror. Aina hoon main. Apne roop baru hoon main. Am I a mirror or am I a face to face? Kuch hairat zyada hoon. That means I'm living in a land of wonderland. Am I a mirror? Am I face to face? Am I living in this land of wonderland? Na jaane aks hoon main. Am I a reflection of myself? Am I a face? Right? Or am I just a mirror? Right? Because that for me is contactless dining. So in sum, what's happening is that we seem to be living in a life of seldom heard, seldom seen, never touched, always felt people. And that for me is possibly the closest that you can come to contactless dining, right? Unless, of course, you want to do virtual dining, which, of course, we're all doing. And I know that our common friend, Kunal, always seems to be busy doing virtual dining, which is a pity that you should ask us to join him as well.
Yeah, but how do you think it will actually be implemented? Is it just some kind of a buzzword that the industry is thrown out? Because it's very difficult to imagine a world where you do not come either in contact with the guest or the food or the service element. So what exactly are we talking about when we say contactless? How is it going to be implemented?
So what I did, Antoine, I wrote down a couple of points that I remember in the the pre-COVID era, and I'm sure you have, like I have, well, this winter or any time you've been to London to the theater, right? And when you go to a London theater, because there's such a large, there's such a, during the intermission, there's such a great rush for drinks that everybody has to pre-buy them. So you go onto the app of whichever theater you're going to, you pre-buy your drinks. They give you a place where you can go and pick it up in the intermission. So let's say I'm number six, and they have a series of shelves. So I go to number six with me and my companions. We go and pick up a set of drinks. There are mixers, there's ice, there's glasses, and so on and so forth. And you have your drink and you go back to the theater. Okay. So for me, that is a pre-COVID experience. The second example that I can think of is is what these guys did in Aloft does. It's a great brand. Well, it's a popular brand, at least in the US. And they have, I remember staying there about 3 years ago, and I never met anybody, right? I mean, the shuttle brought me in. I already had my smart card for some reason. It was lying on the desk with my name. I went up to my room. They had a grab and go. I could go and pick up my stuff. And much to my horror, by the time I checked out and got into the shuttle, I really hadn't met anybody. And I was there for three nights. Okay. I mean, I could have gone to they have another cafe. I probably bounced in, you know, I did see some people in their bar. But otherwise, I didn't meet anybody. Even before that, at the luxury hotel, which is in Chicago, I remember checking in and there was this great, there was a gap of at least 2 yards between me and the next customer. And I was practically on the portico. And I was wondering whether I had done anything wrong. And at that time, I was the general manager of the ITC Moria. And I looked up to the damn GM so well, I thought he'd come and receive me. But to my umbrage, there was nobody there. And I asked him, he said, no, this is a fundamental, physical distancing is a need here, because if you touch somebody, they'll sue you.
Yeah.
So North America had preceded the rest of the world and anyhow creating this lines of passage. That means you had to keep your 2 yard distance between, you know, whoever was checking in. All right.
Right.
Third example that I can think of is actually knock and drop. Now, I don't know whether you've been to ITC Kohinoor, right?
Yes.
And what we did was we introduced the butler box there in the ITC One Room.
Right. Yes.
So the butler box was basically an attribute of luxury, which meant that you could actually give your clothes, your shoes, and even your early morning tea can be placed in the butler box, and they give you a buzz and you come up and open the butler box from your side and slide whatever you need from there, and vice versa. So if you want to place back your laundry, or you want to give your shoes for polishing, you want to put your... Now, you can't do a meal there, but you know, your early morning tea, biscuits, continental breakfast kind of thing. So that is another example. And this is happening now at the ITC Kohinoor, right? And this is not exactly many years ago, although, as I said, this is pre-COVID. Then I remember traveling British Airways, like I'm sure many of you have, and they started the pantry in the business class, which means that after hours, they sprung open the pantry. All you need, if you were hungry and you were working against hours because you're traveling India to, let's say, London, you could go to the pantry. It was not manned. The crew had obviously gone to sleep. I think they're quite unionized. And you could go and get yourself a drink or a snack and so on and so forth and come back and keep back the stuff in a small trough, which was, I suppose, cleared much later. Or for that matter, your business class lounge. You know, you go to one of these airport lounges, apart from the procedure of showing your boarding pass, you really don't meet anybody there. I mean, unless you want to go and cohabit with the passengers and so on and so forth. So when you speak of contactless service, yes, it's possibly happening in many parts of the world, right?
Okay.
You and I were talking yesterday about going to McDonald's and doing a drive-in and picking up a burger or whatever, right? I mean,
so,
okay, but I think your question was more framed towards the luxury segment. rather than
in a manner of speaking, you know. And so Gautam, I remember when I went to Italy many years ago, and you know, in India we're used to having several touch points between the server and the customer.
Yeah.
But I remember over there, it was, I think it was just three or four. They gave you your menu, serve you your water, took your order, serve the food, gave you your bill. I can't imagine something like that happening in India. So how do you imagine this actually being implemented at the restaurant level?
Yeah, so similarly, you've been to ITC Grand Cholas, and you know what we did there. We put the iPad, and we could actually do a lot of stuff there with the iPad. You could order in, you could... But now I think you're talking about, let's say, a main restaurant. And I like what Nakul Anand calls it, because when you called me, I also called him up, since I work informally with the ITC hotels as a friend or whatever. And I was trying to help them with some of their service designs. And I asked him, I said, what do you think of this contactless service? He said, you know, I prefer calling it the contact light service, right?
Okay.
So I like what he said, the contact light service. And what contact light service essentially means, Antoine, so let's simulate it, let's say. Simulate, let's say, a well-known sit-down restaurant.
Okay.
Where there's bowing and scraping and what we call in Hindustani as Ji Hazuri, and, you know.
Exactly, yes.
Yeah, I think, yeah. You know, that the time of Ji Hazuri, the bowing and scraping, and sar, which otherwise seems to be that servile attitude.
This obsequiousness that we demand.
Yeah. And you know, what is important is what has aided us to make a lot of these, what we think are transformational changes over the last so many years, has been the advent of technology. And technology can certainly help us. For instance, I'm living on my own in my flat, and I run a cashless society, because I can order in, I can do my groceries, I can pay my salary to my staff, and so on and so forth. Similarly, now let's look at a restaurant, let's say like Bukhara. Okay.
Great. Perfect example.
I am not a spokesperson for ITC Hotels. I'm only simulating. I know the brand well. So what I can do is I can order in, let's say, for instance, I would love to have a drink, let's say. Okay, so I want, let's say, a scotch, and I want a mixer, and I want a snack, right?
Sure.
And I should order it. So I will do what the English did to me at the theater, right? So the restaurant on the app tells me that my designated time of arrival is 7 p.m. because, as you know, we have a curfew at 9 o'clock. So we need to come in. There is a curfew, at least I know that there is one in Delhi. So I arrive at 7. There's a drink for one placed on my table. Okay, means that if Antoine and Gautam go, there's a table, there's a drink for one for Antoine, there's a drink for one for Gautam. I get a miniature of my scotch, okay, which is mine. I get a glass which has got a sheet which says sanitize for my protection. It has a can of water or a bottle of water which I need. The only thing I've not been able to figure out on my behalf or on their behalf, what do I do with the ice, right?
Ice. Yeah,
so I will need ice. So we have to look for a solution for the ice. Now, what will happen is that descriptively, if I get a pallet for one, and you get a pallet for you. And similarly, like the aviation people do, you get a little sachet, which with a sheath again, or peanuts, or whatever little snack I want. Then you and I are now sitting in in a booth, because they already have bead curtains. Right? So there is a psychological prop between us and the rest of the customers. Both of us have had contactless drink. Okay.
Okay.
You've had your, you've had a beer or a bottle of wine. I've had my whiskey, and this is plausible, because that is what I'm saying. So I'm saying, as far as beverages are concerned, I would certainly put a lot of money on the miniatures, and miniatures have all the varieties in the world, including half pints for wine and half pints for beer. So a drink for one is plausible and possible. That's what the English have been doing for you know, about 30, 40, 50 years is,
right.
Okay. So as far as my meal is concerned, I have also pre-ordered my meal. Now, for this, I need a hiatus. So either I wait for the server to come to my table, or I and Antoine go out and get some fresh air. Okay. Walk out of the restaurant. In the meanwhile, the server puts down a little platter for one. Now, Antoine has ordered his tikka, his kebab, his bread. Bread, again, I'm saying bread is something which I think we all need to work on, because our breads are very big. Can we cut them into two? I don't know. As I said, I'm not a spokesperson for ITC Hotels, but I'm only simulating this because I know the brand well. So you get your platter, I get my platter, we get some form of cutlery, okay, honestly speaking, because I think it's important to bring in some amount of sanitization and hygiene and purpose and confidence. And similarly, once I also get a nice wrapper with my wet wipe. You know, so after my meal is done, I use my wet wipe and so on and so forth. Whether my platter has a dessert or whether it has no dessert, and I need to do my hiatus once again and, you know, do a fresh air and come for dessert, I don't know the answers. But yes, I think it's plausible. Similarly, by the time I check out, the same app has already registered my meal experience. It has served my meal experience. It has charged me, and I use one of those payment gateways to make my payment. I give my gratuity, I give my comments, and so on and so forth, and I leave. All right. Now, there will be contest. There will be somebody who, unless I get revolving doors there, right, or I get a digital door, I will need to be admitted, right?
Right.
That they have. The kitchen will continue to happen, except that they'll have to create a little more distance between all the cooks who are standing there, all right, because they have to invoke confidence. So I think, Antoine, in a small nutshell, what I'm saying is that it's plausible, all right. Whether it's contactless, I'm not very sure. Otherwise, you know, why should there be a luxury hotel at all? So I like what Nakul said. Duckle says he likes to call it contact light, and I fully support that. All right.
Gautam, where does the service element come into a situation like this? You know, because one of the things that you do go to hotel is for, maybe not even if you're not saying the G Hazuri, but some element, some amount of interaction. For me, this sounds like a very, very sterile encounter.
Yeah. Well, Antoine, you know, I think the other thing that we have to learn is that the COVID is a flu, all right? And it seems to, by and large, be a mild symptomatic flu, right? Now, it may be fatal for older people like me. But for younger people than me, it seems to be fine. They seem to be, many people are getting it and they become immune to it. And therefore, I saw the research that a lot of people have done, including the ITC team. And I was very impressed with what research they've done. Is that first of all, I think there was a raison d'etre that we should keep out the COVID, right? We've done so in the past, you know, with the SARS and so on and so forth. The second one was to try and contain it, right? And the third, and the reality now is that You have to coexist with it. We have to coexist with it. I'm only giving you the nuts and bolts of what is plausible. I'm not saying even for a minute that that is what is going to happen. I'm sure there's going to be lots of bowing and scraping, because, you know, as Nakul rightly says, that seldom seen but always felt. So there will always be some interaction, right? All I'm saying is that nobody's going to be shaking your hands anymore. And the reason I was told by somebody interesting is that the reason why people were shaking hands, it was they wanted to prove to their companion or to their or to the other protagonist that they didn't carry a gun. Right. And that's why this shaking of hands came through. But I think if you look at our own background, our own past, and you come from Mangalore, you know, everybody loves to eat in little thalis, you know. We've been generationally been eating in little thalis or eating individual meals. So I think meals for one, whether it's served by the bearer or whether he wears gloves or whether he wears a PPE kit or whether he wears a visor or he wears a mask and glamorizes the mask, whether you get cutlery or, I mean, this is hypothesis. But I'm sure a luxury chain like ITC or the others for that matter will glamorize this nuts and bolts operation that we are now talking about.
Yeah. Gautam, would you care to speculate how this might be implemented at a standalone restaurant? That is something that is outside of the luxury circuit. Do you think it will be easier or more difficult?
You know, Antoine, I'm a great protagonist. I love the restaurant. And thanks to people like you, I've started engaging with restaurants. Otherwise, I was living in one little oyster of my own. But then you put me to the cleaners and gave me a hard time and made me judge all these restaurants. And then I had to go to all those...
all those terrible standalones in Gurgaon.
The Thacker House and all those. Anyway, I must say that the three or four that you sent me to, I really loved. I love the O Pedro and Bombay K. I love them. Okay, I love Olive. I love a lot of these places. You know, I'm saying if the owner or the promoter is visionary, right? Then they'll make it happen. You know, if the owner is visionary, they'll make it happen. You know, capacity utilization is not going to be the winner, right? So if you're going to be looking at capacity and your revenue per occupied or available cover, then you have a problem on your hands, right? And remember that we are still dealing with a curfew. So your meal periods are certainly going to propel. So would we be like the West and open our lunch at 5 o'clock? And the answer seems to be yes. Because if my departure is going to be 8 p.m., because I can't serve my meal till 9 if my curfew starts at 9. And driving time in New Delhi or in Bombay is anything... 1 hour plus. I mean, it doesn't matter whether we have traffic or no traffic. But just imagine at 8 p.m. and everybody wants to go home, right? And there's the same amount of traffic to get back before the curfew. So I don't know. But I think restaurants like the ones that I've spoken about will probably have to do one turnover unless they open at lunch and then don't close. And therefore, these cafes become like bistros. You know, they become like bistros. They open at 12. Or they open for breakfast, for instance. That's an opportunity also. They open for breakfast and they close by 9 o'clock, which means that they operate two shifts. And I agree with what you're saying, you know, that you cannot have a dehumanizing experience. That means that there will be, you know, in the cast of characters that involves you and me, Antoine, there's... We also need to prove to the establishment that we are clean.
Yeah.
Right? Like the establishment is now, everybody's talking about that poor establishment to say, are you guys safe? Are you working my confidence? So I had a little bit of an argument with one German chap who was giving me a hard time. And he was calling from Berlin, the city which I love. And he said, I've done, Mr. Anand, we've done our research and hotels are no longer going to be favored destination. We would rather go and live in a bed and breakfast. So then I asked him, I said, Hans, you keep blaming the establishment, but are you carrying some sort of certification that you are COVID free? Because the establishment needs to ask you the same question. Exactly. To say, Hans, I hope that you are not a serial offender. And just because we are servile and bowing and scraping and doing Ji Hazuri, and you come, so the cast of characters now includes people like you and me. It includes the establishment and it certainly includes the way we've come. You know, have you driven our own car? Have you taken one of those Ubers? Have you taken an aircraft? So I think the cast of characters will have to be widened. All right. But sure, there is there's a great need for atmospherics and there's a great need for heritage. I mean, you can't do away with all the fun of going to a restaurant, right?
Absolutely. One of the questions, Gautam, that has I've kind of been pondering and kind of been wondering is that, say you have a restaurant, a fairly full restaurant, and one of your customers starts coughing or starts sneezing, you know, what happens then? I mean, how do you, I mean, which is related to the point of how do you actually ensure, I mean, you can ensure as an organization that the environment is sanitized, but how do you ensure that the guests are also, is there a way to do that?
I think, I agree with you. That's exactly the point that I was debating with Nakul Anand. And I said, look, it's he said, look, it's very simple that they will have to be, you know, like the Aadhaar card. We've all been asked to carry the Arogya Setu app, right?
Right.
Right. The Arogya Setu app, which... So, formulate some methodology ways, you know, for instance, you know, when you check into a hotel today, you have to show your Aadhaar card. Right? Or some sort of identity. You go to the airport, you have to show your driving license or whatever else. And I think the Arogya Setu app is becoming more and more compulsory. So there'll have to be some guarantee that customers will have to take, right, when they go to a restaurant and prove. That's number one. I suspect that most customers who leave or go to a restaurant will also be carrying some personal protection. So similarly, you know, your mask, your sanitizer, your glove, etc., etc. Now, if the customer starts coughing on the premises, then the best thing to do is to tactfully ask the customer to, you know, to do so in the privacy of some other location within the hotel, and you can't throw them out. But there is some sort of like you've done in the past, and we've had irate customers in the past, and we've gently had to. They may not have been coughing, but you know. Let me show you. I've had the displeasure of meeting customers who are quite offensive. I met lots of nice customers, but I've also met some unhappy customers who made me unhappy and everybody else. Yeah, so there must be a dilemma, right? There will be again. I'm saying unless they, so therefore unless you start the practice now, right? And learn from the experience, you really won't know. It's an imperfect world, you know. There's going to be lots of glitches. There's going to be lots to learn. I'm sure that the establishment will do their physical distancing, what the WHO guidelines are there, etc., etc. Tactfulness is a luxury hotel's attribute. Rights of admissions are reserved. The rights of exits are not, right? So I think it's going to become more and more important to admit people with the prerequisite, attestations, like they do when they take your room booking. You know, Mr. Lewis, your Aadhaar card, your PAN number, your credit card, etc., etc. Yeah, it's going to happen.
Okay, so Gautam, I'm going to take a question that someone has sent in. And this is from Mr. Ankit Aluwalia. And he says that a lot of restaurants are going bankrupt. Do you suggest putting any further investment in changing the furniture or putting the glass in between a table for 2 and 4 in 48 cover space? So you're looking at a situation where restaurants, hotels are already financially burdened. Is this something advisable? Is this something absolutely necessary?
Well, you know, you'll have to, I think that the creating notional partitions or physical partitions or I think it's, you know, it's about invoking confidence, right? I know the restaurants are broke. I know there's no money to be paid. But I know a lot of visionary employers who kept all their employees in, you know, on their roles. I know that ITC Hotels, and as I said, I'm not their spokesperson, but everybody's been paid. Everybody's kept on road, you know, with a lot of dignity. And yes, there will be a requirement. You cannot have cheek by jowl, face-to-face interaction. It's like the poetry I just mentioned to you. You know, it's in the restaurants, it's to the restaurant's advantage if they bring into these elements of notional privacy and safety. Hmm. For instance, this customer starts coughing. If he starts or she starts coughing, then they should, he or she should cough in their own booth rather than in a free restaurant, because then the whole restaurant will get up and go. Right?
Right.
So I think some emotional partitions, I'm not saying private dining and all that, but I'm saying individual dining, single dining, private dining, it's okay. And it's okay to have glass partitions so that you can see through this, you know. You know what, there's somebody, Ankit, for instance, sitting next door, I'm saying hi to Ankit. But, you know, that touching Ankit, who I'd love to hug otherwise, would not going to happen in a very long time. Okay, so restaurants, for whatever it's worth, I know there's a beast of burden, but I think banks are flush with money. I think the government has been liberal as far as monies are concerned. The banks, for good establishments, go and take a working capital loan, should not be a problem right now. Okay. And these are, you know, we've done so. Remember when what happened when the September 11th happened, or when our own terrorism happened? Everybody had to go through their processes for renewing the three rings of security. You know, and lots of money. And similarly, now is the time for the three rings of sanitization. You know,
that's so a good point.
So establishments who bring in the three rings of sanitization are the establishments that will. That means the core ring is the safest ring, right? And I'm saying customers will pay a premium, because there's also going to be what they call as revenge eating. Because I haven't eaten for years, right? I know there's a lot of people who are wanting to do revenge shopping. In fact, Nakul told me this, that, you know, people are going to be going on binges for shopping and going to binges for eating, because we haven't been out for the last 3-4 months, right?
Absolutely.
3.5-4 months. So, Ankit, please tell him from my side, yes, it's a small investment. It's not difficult. It's easy these days. Perplex sheets are available. You can create notional partitions, and you can even embed them with speakers, you know, so that you can have communication with each other to say, hi, how are you? Across the or use your phones, man. Damn it, use your phones.
To speak to each other. Another buzzword that we're hearing, Gautam, we spoke to a lot about contact designing, but another buzzword is multi-skilling. What does this mean? What is the expectation of a staff to be multi-skilled?
You know, it's a very irritating thing. Anyway, I find this more irritating because I keep hearing people who want to dehumanize their experience. They're looking for... See, I think that India needs employment. You know, we must, as an industry, we must continue to be... You know, our soft part is our best part. Right, we are not an industrial empire, but we have great soft power. You know, the reason I like going to O Pedro and Bombay Canteen is because, I mean, the food is great, but the people are lovely, absolutely. You know, the last time I went there, I even bought the steward and the young lady one of those nice custard pies. I was so happy with the way, and I was paying, by the way, or somebody was paying. You know, such that engagement, as you rightly said. So this multi-skilling, I think, came out of this irrational smart hotels who, and I think this is a Western hegemony on us, because, you know, like I told you about Aloft and the formerly the luxury. So I think they made you do everything. Now technology is doing that, Antoine. We've all started multitasking. Thanks to technology. Yeah. Now, you and I are speaking on Instagram. We could have spoken on Facebook. We could have done
Zoom.
So in that cliched world of very ordinary people, of what I call as a species of poor hotel etiquette, they would make one associate do the loo and do the room service and check you in. You know, it's like you come to my home and I have one cook who's my butler and housekeeper. So when Antoine gets up in the morning, my cook and the butler will come and give you tea, he'll make your bed, he'll do your clothes, he'll do your ironing. You know, it's that kind of species, right? But I don't know whether we want to see the same individual. And, you know, there'll be a lot of attrition, right? Because technology is doing the multitasking anyhow. So if you want to and the reason you brought in technology, Antoine, is because it overcame human error. right? But if you're going to take that same multitasking and embed it in an individual, then you're not overcoming human error. You'll make multiple human errors. The same resource who did poorly in housekeeping will do poorly in food and beverages, can possibly do poorly in your baggage delivery and so on and so forth. Right? So I'm not very sure that multi-skilling is the answer. I think we love India because of its soft power, and our soft power comes from its people. People like you and me, I have invested my life on people. My job is to help people perform better. And I would rather have somebody who does, for instance, you know, the chefs. Every chef is now doing biryani. I mean, there seems to be a scandal. If you look at Instagram or Facebook, everybody is making biryani. You know, you understand? Everybody's making that nice fish curry that you were showing off the other day and greedily having the whole thing. Everybody's making fish curry.
Absolutely.
It doesn't work like that. Yeah. You know, so if you look at the classical Indian divisions, the kebab chief makes kebab, the naan bhai makes bread. At the Bukhara, there is one particular gentleman whose name I should not take, who only does breads. You know, he needs the bread, he makes the bread, he chooses the gluten count, he prepares what they call espiedas, the sizes. I mean, there's one guy who does the breads. Simple as that.
We have gone way over time, but I'm still going to take one question. And this is from Sanchita Arora, who asks, so you mean the creativity to deal with social distancing will be the key driver for footfall?
I am not saying even for a minute social distancing. I think physical distancing, you know. Socially, we are now, we're active on Instagram. You have some audience. I'm speaking with you. I'm not speaking to the mirror. So, but physical distancing, I think, is what the norm, which is being said again and again. And yes, you please. And I'm saying, Sanchit, don't be a cowboy. You know, there's a problem. And that is what is creating the problem. Third mentality is creating a problem. So physical distances, yes, absolutely. To protect yourself and protect your beholder or your customer.
Well, Gautam, as always...
I'm going to end with a little couplet because I'm going to cheer you up a little bit, if you don't mind. Okay.
Yes, yes, absolutely. That would be lovely to kind of get something positive to end with.
So there's a very nice couplet by Faiz. Faiz Ahmed Faiz was one of, generationally, one of the great poets of South Asia.
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah.
And he says that, Dil na umeed to nahi, dil haak, na umeed to nahi, na kaam hi to hai. Dil na umeed to nahi, na kaam hi to hai, lambi hai meri gam ki shaam, but shaam hi to hai. What it means is that the heart is not hopeless, it's only helpless. Long are my evening grieves or peeves, but you know, they're just evenings. There'll always be a tomorrow. Thank you, Antoine.
Great.
For this fantastic conversation.
You so much. Thank you so much, Gautam. And yes, I absolutely enjoyed chatting with you, as I always do. So looking forward to meeting you again in person, hopefully very soon. And thank you, everyone, for being a part of the conversation, for joining in and listening. And our next conversation is going to be on the coming Wednesday. We have Sudeep Puttatunda, who is the managing director of Coldplay and also a food scientist. And we are going to be talking about nutrition and keeping healthy in the lockdown. So if you guys on Wednesday the 3rd, I believe. Have a great day, have a great evening, and keep safe. See you around, Gautam.
Bye-bye. Cheers, Antoine. See you soon. Right. Bye.
Cheers.